Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Well, Lord, we thank you tonight. It's good to be in the house of the Lord. It's good to be with God's people. It's good to have those of you that are joining us tonight. We're coming into the house of the Lord once again to pray. How many believe in prayer tonight?
Amen.
I mean, know that God hears and answers prayer. Hallelujah.
Yes.
We know that tonight. We're confident about that. And so we want to join together. We're going to worship. We're going to pray. We're going to make declarations before the Lord because we know there's power in prayer. So let's just welcome tonight the presence of the Lord in this house, and let's just enter into his gates with thanksgiving, come into his courts with praise. Lord, we just give you thanks tonight, for you are worthy. You are the Almighty God. You're the everlasting from everlasting, O mighty God. And we worship you tonight as we enter in, Lord, to this time of waiting before you, of prayer, of worship, because we know, Lord, that you hear us when we pray. We know, God, that you are a faithful God. You're faithful and you are true. And God, you see every one of us, Lord, here tonight. You see, Lord, those that have a desire to call on the name of the Lord. And God, we understand tonight that the Lord Jesus Christ and the power of our God is the only hope tonight for our lives, for the city, for the nation, God, for the world. The only hope is found in Jesus Christ our Lord. And so tonight we look to you, we call upon you, we want to lift you up because you said if we would lift you up, that you would draw us into your presence. And so, Lord, we want to be drawn into the presence of the Lord tonight. We want you, God, to show forth your power. Again, as you look, Lord, your eyes run to and fro. God, we ask you, Lord, tonight to settle on this house. Settle on us, O God, as we lift up our voices to pray and to call upon you. Lord, to stand in agreement because there is power in agreement, Lord, where two or more, you said, agree on anything, that we have those things that we pray for. So tonight we release that faith, Almighty God. We release that faith in you who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we could ask or think. Lord, tonight let us not be limited, Lord, by what we see. Lord, but let us have supernatural vision to see the glory and the power of God working. Lord, let the prayers of us tonight in this house, Lord, let it begin to change the atmosphere. Lord, in this city over Spring, Texas, Lord, like when that young man stood up and began to pray, 17-year-old young man, and as he prayed, there in the Hebrides, oh, mighty God, the power of God began to move from one young man praying. And Lord, the revival came, Lord, to Wales. Lord, I just pray for the mighty anointing of the Holy Spirit to be released in us, released in this house. And Lord, that there's power in our prayer tonight. Hallelujah. So we worship you. Come on, lift up your voice tonight and just tell the Lord how great he is, that he's a mighty God, that he's everlasting, that he's the King of glory. He's the great I am. He's the mighty everlasting God. And tonight we praise you, we worship you, and we look to you, Almighty God.
It's so overwhelming.
Surrender, and I will make room for you. Sing it again. Here is where I lay it down. Here is where I lay it down. Every burden, every crown. This is my surrender. This is my surrender. Here is where I lay it down. Every lion, every doubt. This is my surrender. I will make room for you to do whatever you want to. To do whatever you want to. I will make room for you. To do whatever you want to. To do whatever you want to. Have your way, Lord. Uproot everything you never meant to be planted in my life, Lord. Break down every stronghold. Have your way, Lord. Sing, shake up the ground. Shake up the ground of all my tradition. Shake up the ground. Shake up the ground of all my tradition. Break down the walls of all my religion. Your way is better. Your way is better. Shake up the ground of all my tradition. Break down the walls. And this is my desire. This is my desire to honor.
before. Our desire is to please you. Our desire, Lord, to worship you in spirit and in truth, oh Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. We love you. We love you, Lord. It is our desire to worship you. It is our desire to live for you. Oh Lord, it is our desire to be transformed into your image, oh Lord. Oh, we pray, do your perfect work in every one of our hearts, in our lives. Bring this work to completion, oh Lord, even this year. We pray, Lord, do a mighty work within us, oh God. A mighty work, hallelujah. Hallelujah. And cause us to go forth, Lord, in the power of your Holy Spirit, the power of your anointing, and do the works, Lord, that you've called us to do. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bold deeds and daring acts for the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. They that know their God, hallelujah, will do bold deeds. Hallelujah. And daring acts for the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise your mighty name. We exalt you. We thank you, Lord, for your goodness. We thank you, Lord, for your mercy. We thank you, Lord, for your faithfulness. Oh, we thank you. Hallelujah. We praise you. We exalt you. Hallelujah. We praise, oh Lord. We praise with the new song. Hallelujah. That you place within our heart. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, that we can praise you. Hallelujah. No matter what the weather is, no matter what the temperature is, no matter what things look like on the outside, Lord, we determine that we're going to praise you. Hallelujah. We're going to praise, we're going to praise, we're going to praise. Because our God has all power in heaven and in earth. Hallelujah. So we praise and we glorify your name. We exalt you, for you're a good God. You're a mighty God. Hallelujah. What a loving Savior. What a mighty Redeemer. Hallelujah. You save to the uttermost. Hallelujah. No one is beyond your reach. Hallelujah. 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 We pray, Lord, tonight, Spring, Texas for God. Hallelujah. Let this city be known as a city filled with the fullness of the Spirit of the living God. Pour out your Spirit, Lord, upon Spring, Texas, anew and afresh. Let the springs of living water, oh, be abundant in Spring, Texas. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let the glory of the Lord be poured out upon all of your children, all of your people in this city. Oh, Lord. Hallelujah. Pour out your mighty miracles. Transform lives with your healing, your deliverance, your mighty power, your displays of glory. Hallelujah. You are mighty to save. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We invite you, come, Holy Spirit. Come, Holy Spirit. Come, Holy Spirit. Transform the landscape of Spring, Texas. Hallelujah. 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 Make it the dwelling place of the Holy Spirit. Oh, hallelujah. 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 We praise and exalt your name, Lord. We glorify you, for you are good. You are good. You are good. Your mercies endure forever. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We exalt and praise you. Hallelujah. 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 Well, the word says, in the mouth of two or three witnesses, let the thing be established. Hallelujah. And so I have some good news to share tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Good news to share. And it just occurred to me when I'd heard a word this week from Charlie Shemp. And I thought, man, that sounds so familiar. That sounds so like, man, I heard somebody else saying the same thing. The title of the thing for Charlie Shemp was called Divine Reversals. Divine Reversals. And even when he was making his presentation, he used the term boomerang. There's going to be a big boomerang. And you know, there was another word just a couple weeks ago released on March the 6th from Tim Sheets. And the title of his was called Boomerangs. boomerangs. Hallelujah. And so I want to read a couple of excerpts from this and a couple of scriptures to go with it before we pray. But this is an amazing word. It's an upbeat, positive word for the U.S. and for the people even around the world. But it says, the Holy Spirit said, this is from Tim Sheets, the Holy Spirit said, boomerang is releasing upon strategies of darkness by my angels as my ecclesia has asked for. Plots will boomerang. Evil plans will boomerang. Schemes of darkness will boomerang. Battle plans will boomerang. Power systems generating reinforcements of sin to destroy my will boomerang. They will experience the boomerang of their proposed destruction. Plans of destruction will certainly come back upon them, and freedom from bondage will be manifested once again in this nation, and the King's redemption will activate in all 50 states. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I heard that and I thought, thank you, Lord. That is a powerful word. That's what one of the things that we've been praying for. We've been praying for these last 4 years. He went on to say, divine reversals are now releasing. Divine reversals. And he started out, he'd had a dream, and it was about a big giant angel. How many of you know that our God has some big giant angels? Hallelujah. And they can do great things for the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. So it says, the days of boomerang have begun. You will see visible public displays of undeniable reversals. My heirs will rejoice as what was meant for my people's harm will turn for good. It said, I can, I have, and I will stand with them. I can, I have, and I will cause my ecclesia to prevail. I can, I have, and I will anoint history makers. I can, I have, and I will anoint new leaders. I can, I have, and I will change America's history. I can, I have, and I will pour out my spirit, and I will shake hell. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's the word coming from God Almighty. Hallelujah. And his proposal is he's going to shake hell. Hallelujah. Amen. So we're praying right in with that word. And like I said, I'd heard Charlie Shupp talking about it this week, and he was talking about divine reversals, that God is going to come by his will and by his purpose and turn things around. And so we want to just continue to pray into that. And as I was contemplating those words, a couple of scriptures came to my mind that I wanted to share. One of them comes from the book of Jonah. And this is what it says in Jonah chapter 4. Verse 11. Should I not have compassion on Nineveh, the great city in which there are more than 120,000 innocent persons who do not know the difference between their right and left hand and are not yet accountable for sin, as well as many blameless animals? So God was not only concerned about the individuals, the people, the souls of those people that were in Nineveh, but he was even concerned about the animals, the blameless animals that were there. And so he was having this word with Jonah. And Jonah actually got upset that God wasn't going to, that he wasn't going to send destruction on Nineveh. But what happened? The people repented, and the Lord our God relented because he longs to have mercy and compassion. That's the desire of his heart. Do you know your God? Do you know the mercy and the compassion of your God? The other scriptures from 2 Peter chapter 3. verse 9, it says, the Lord does not delay as though he were unable to act, and is not slow about his promise, as some count slowness, but is extraordinarily patient toward you, not wishing that any should perish, but for all to come to repentance. Amen. So that's why we're here. We're continuing to pray. We're praying for this nation. We're praying for this city. We're praying for our family and our family members to come to repentance so that they can know the mercy and the compassion of our great God, like we've known and like we've experienced in our own lives. And so I just want us to continue to pray. Lord God, pour out your mercy, pour out your glory, pour out your blessings. So let's pray tonight. Lord, we love you and we're so thankful that we can come and gather together and call upon your name. Lord, we know that you hear us. We've heard and seen many answers to our prayers. And so we praise you for answered prayers. And we thank you for answered prayers tonight. And so, Lord, even as in light of these scriptures, we're praying, pour out, pour out, pour out your mercy upon this nation. Pour out your grace upon this nation. And we pray for supernatural, divinely inspired reversals. Supernatural, divine reversals in this nation. Lord, that once again, this will be one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And so, Lord, we want to see revival from sea to shining sea. We want to see revival from the south all the way to the northern border of the United States. And even beyond that, even up into Canada. Canada needs God. They need an outpouring, Lord. So, Lord, we pray, pour out your spirit on all of North America. Oh, pour it out, pour it out, pour it out. Let us see with our eyes the supernatural revival. Oh, sweep across this nation and across this land and across the world. Pour out supernatural anointing. Oh, Lord, that will transform lives, that will show your mercy, show your compassion, show your glory and your greatness for all the world to see. Lord, demonstrate your glory. Demonstrate for all the world to see. Oh, Lord, pour out your mighty miracles from heaven. Oh, miracle healings, deliverance, and anointing. Oh, God, we praise you and we are so thankful for your goodness. We praise you for your goodness. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you for your loving kindness. We thank you, Lord, that you're not willing that any should perish. Oh, but you've called all men everywhere to repentance. Hallelujah. During this time, during this season, come, come, come. Oh, we pray. Let the nations come. Let the people come and let them repent and let them declare that you are our God. You are our God, you are one God, and you are great and mighty, glorious and worthy of praise. So we praise you tonight, and we just continue to say, Lord, pour out your spirit like we've never seen before. Pour it out, let it be like a thick veil upon the land. Pour out your spirit and let people be filled with the Holy Spirit. Oh, Lord, and let them be transformed in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Oh, we praise your mighty name. We praise and exalt your mighty name. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Begin to appear to men. Oh, Lord, begin to speak into people's lives. Begin to appear to men in their dreams. Oh, Lord, we pray that we'll hear of more testimonies, just like the transformation of Saul to Paul. Oh, that they will be... Oh, they will see a light, a bright light, Lord, and that you will speak into their lives. Lord, we've heard about it happening in Muslim countries. Let it happen in the United States of America. Oh, Lord, begin to speak into people's dreams. Begin to speak into their heart. Begin to speak into their life. Oh, Lord, we pray, transform people. Change their hearts. And, Lord, we pray, let us hear the testimonies of a mighty outpouring of the Spirit of the living God. Oh, hallelujah. thank you for your goodness. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for your loving kindness. And we just praise you, Lord, in all that you're doing. Oh, show forth your glory. Hallelujah.
Scriptures, and then I want to talk about what I'm going to pray about just a hair. Okay. So I'm going to talk about what I'm going to, first I'm going to read a couple scriptures, then I'm going to talk about what's on my heart. In Psalm 17:7, it says, "Show thy marvelous loving kindness, O thou that saves. By your right hand, save them which put their trust in you from those that rise up against them." When does it say, read that scripture? And then I wanted to read a scripture in 2 Thessalonians 2. Because we need saving from those that are rising up against us. You know, everything they're promoting out of our government is aimed against God and aimed against Christians. It is. It says, and for this cause, God shall send them a strong delusion. Why? Because the Antichrist spirit is running the show, which is what we're seeing, right? Or it appears anyway. And for this cause, God shall send them a strong delusion that they should believe a lie. Well, Pastor, I think they've already got it. If they could believe that killing babies is right, that given all of our resources around the world and bankrupting us, not making us energy independent, if they can think that's the truth, they're deluded, right? And weaken our nation the way they are. The things they're proposing weaken us. They weaken us. And so that strong delusion, God, because I went around not understanding how they could do this and how they could do that. And God showed me that he sent them a delusion. Well, that changes the whole perspective quite a bit. So that helped me quite a bit. And so those that are rising up against us, we got to know they're against us. Those that are rising up against us, God says he's going to save those that put their trust in him. And so we've been doing that a long time here. And like Paul said, you know, because what is on my heart is to pray into what they're doing in Washington, what they're doing in state capitals, those that are rising up against us. And they've infiltrated all the high places so that they can change laws and change policies and all that kind of thing. And so it came up in my heart to pray that God would do again what he did for Joshua and other armies when they would all these armies coming against him. And God would discomfit the enemy, the Bible says. And he would cause them to become confounded, especially when they praised.
Absolutely.
When they praised. And we do plenty of that here too. So I'm praising God tonight.
Right.
Because I believe that God is going to confound those who are, you know, right now, they're up there in Washington. They're behind closed doors. They're trying to figure out how to steal the election. They're trying to figure out how to get around Trump's, getting the lead of everything. They're trying to figure out they're plotting evil is what they're doing. How can they get the abortion back, what the Supreme Court did? How can they do all these things? They're back there behind the scenes doing all that. I know they are. And so let them plot. That's what I say. Let them plot. God will confound our enemies, because you know what we do? I don't know about y'all, and I've said this before, but for me, when I come here on Wednesday night and I get to agree with my brothers and sisters in Christ over issues and other things, I'm all of my burden is erased, because there's more power with us here. And I pray in my prayer closet, I pray, but I'm telling you here, I it's like I can rest. I know it's solid, and God is looking down at us. He sees us, and he knows we're a people after his heart. He knows that we're a people that want to see people saved. He knows we're a people that love him and want to see justice in the earth. He knows that about our hearts. He knows we've been transformed. And so when we pray in unity here together, he's listening and he's going to answer. So I'm going to pray a prayer about the fact that God is going to confound our enemy. So y'all, let's just agree about it, right? Right. Yes, let's just agree about it. Father, how we thank you, God, that we have power with God. Lord, you've given us hearts that long for you, like David, for the water brooks, Lord. We long for you. And Lord, we know what your word says about how you've dealt with enemies in the Old Testament. We've seen it in your word, and we believe your word. And Father, I'll just use that one example, and we could use many, of what you did with Joshua. And what you did as they faced an army, the praisers praised, and the enemy was confounded, and they destroyed each other. They got confused. Lord, we call down by your mighty power a delusion upon Washington, D.C., that as they're behind those closed doors and they're plotting evil, you hate evil thinking. You hate it. God, we hate it too. It destroys, even on a very small scale, it destroys. I watch it destroy people who think people are thinking this and that, and how it destroys them and everybody around them. Father, I pray you'll look in on those secret rooms and that you will confound their thinking. They'll come up with all these plots that cause them to destroy their plans. Lord, they're going to dig a pit and fall in it. We call on your what your word says is true. Lord, you said if we ask anything according to your will, that it would be done for us by our Father that's in heaven. So, Lord, we call your word back to you. Lord, we call it back to you, filled with faith, God, that as they plot, you're going to cause them to be confused, and everything they try to do will go awry. God, I ask that whatever they've got plotted for this election, that you will cause it to come to nothing, that it will go haywire on them, and they won't even know what happened. Father, we just lift this up to you. God, you be the God of this election. You be the God of all those plans they have against the children of our nation, all the plans they have against Christians and godliness, God, all the perversions that they come up with, God. Lord, we put it in your hands and we say, thy will be done on this earth, in our country, in our Washington, D.C., as you would have it done in heaven. We call that down in Jesus' name. Amen.
Both of your two, to both of your points, the scripture Psalms 35 came up to me. Psalms 35 says, plead my cause, O Lord. Those who strive with me, fight against those who fight against me. Take hold of shield and buckler. Stand up for my help. Also draw out the spear and stop those who pursue me. Say to my soul, I am your salvation. Let those be put to shame and brought to dishonor who seek after my life. And let those be turned back and brought to confusion who plot my hurt. Let them be like chaff before the wind, and let the angel of the Lord chase them. Let their way be dark and slippery, and let the angel of the Lord pursue them. For without cause they have hidden their net for me in a pit, which they have dug without cause for my life. Let destruction come upon him unexpectedly, and let his net that he has hidden catch himself. Into the very destruction let him fall. And my soul shall be joyful in the Lord. It shall rejoice in his salvation. Psalms 35. Literally everything both of y'all said.
Awesome. Praise the Lord.
Well, Father God, I thank you, Lord. I thank you that you are our shield and buckler. I thank you that you make our path straight, that you make your path straight before us. I thank you, Father God, that you steady us as we walk, that you make it to where our feet don't hit a stone, that our feet don't slip, Lord. But I thank you that you, the angel of the Lord, is chasing down our enemies, Father God. These people who hate America, these people who hate the Judeo-Christian foundations that we have in this nation, I thank you that you are chasing them down. I thank you that you are exposing every head of the enemy. And I thank you that you are rooting it out in the name of Jesus. I thank you that you, in the name of Jesus, that you are the one who is raising up the remnant. I thank you, Father God, that the gates of hell shall not prevail in this nation. I thank you that you have put a strong hunger in the bellies of your people, Father God. That we will fast and we will stand for you, Father God. We will stand in the gap. Lord, I thank you that you are sweeping through this nation again, Father. Again, Lord, as we are in the final hours of the last days, Lord, that you are the difference that this nation needs, Father. In a conversation I had in my Bible study this morning, it hit me. It's something that's been on my heart for a while. It hit me when the person said, "Oh, I don't know if maybe if it came to my kids, I don't think if it was anybody other than my kids, I would never renounce the Lord." I said, "The days are coming where you very well might have to watch your kids die in front of you. And you have to ask yourself, will I renounce the Lord? You need to be as wise as a serpent, but as gentle as a dove. If you were as wise as a serpent, ask yourself, if I was the enemy, how would I take me out? If I was the enemy, where is my weakness? For me, it's my family. The Lord brought me through a season recently where I had to think about what if with all these illegal immigrants and criminals coming over our borders, what if I had to watch my children die in front of me? He asked me plainly, would you still serve me if I took away everything I blessed you with? I felt like Abraham. When he's like, I gave you a son, are you willing to give him back? Who do you love more? Do you love the blessing or do you love me? I tell you what, I cried, but I said, you. I love you more. Because without you, I wouldn't have this family. And I know that I will see them again. And these Christians looked at me like I was crazy. But it's true. If you know that you have a weakness, ask the Lord to help you. Lord, make me strong where I am weak. You are my strength. Anything else isn't enough. The only way that I can stand in the final days is only by your strength. It's only by your grace. It's only by your mercy. As we are walking out into these final days, we need to be the ones that says, no, I will not bow to Baal. No, I will not kiss his face. I don't care what you do to me. I don't care what you take from me. But my God will be the one who reigns supreme.
Amen.
You are a loser then. You're a loser now. And you have already lost.
Amen. That's right.
And that's not going to change. So I just challenge you guys this week that as you go into your prayer room, that you ask yourself, Holy Spirit, reveal to me where I am weak.
Right.
Reveal to me where I need to lay it at your feet. Reveal to me where the enemy can come in like a thief and build me up. Build me up in your glory. Build me up in your honor, Lord, so that I can be an effective warrior in this time. Because I refuse to be sidelined by the enemy.
Amen.
He cannot have me. He cannot have my family. And I pray in the name of Jesus, he will not have any of you. As I look around, I see a room full of people who are ready to fight. A room full of people who are not willing to lay down anything of the Lord. I thank you for it, Father. I thank you for every person in here, Lord. I thank you that you are raising them up, that you are strengthening all of us in the name of Jesus. I thank you that you are preparing each one of us for battle. I thank you, Lord, that as we walk into rooms, atmospheres change. I thank you, Lord, that the devil doesn't have the final say that we do. Lord, you working in us and through us is the change this world's going to see. He can't have this nation. It's our nation. It is one nation under God, indivisible. He cannot have this nation. And it's going to start with each one of us in the name of Jesus.
Fire of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you for boldness. Thank you for courage to speak out what some of us won't. Father, we thank you, Lord. We ask that you bless her and keep her, Lord. Oh, Father, we just thank you. You know, the prophets continue to speak about the eclipse coming up. And you know, there's a lot of biblical events that are shaped by the lunar and solar eclipses. In the days of Herod, there was a crisis called the Golden Eagle Incident. Herod had placed a golden eagle over the entrance of the temple of God. And he said he was doing it as a dedication to the Lord, but it was regarded as a desecration by the rabbis, Matthias and Judas. And so they pulled the eagle down, and Herod had them burned alive. When that happened, there was a blood moon the night Herod killed these two rabbis. It's the only reference to a lunar eclipse in all the writings of Josephus. And in the ancient world, an eclipse was regarded as an omen or a judgment. For Josephus, the eclipse on the night after Herod put to death the two rabbis was a sign of displeasure from God. Immediately after the eclipse, Herod got physically sick and started suffering, and he died between the eclipse and Passover. It's God's solemn judgment on Herod because he put to death individuals more righteous than himself. We're seeing that in our own land, what you discussed, Paul, what you said, all the things that happen. You know, there, as we spoke about, I spoke about a couple weeks ago, there's been a golden statue that's been brought to Texas that is like an Ishtar, and the same statue, but smaller, was put on the New York City courthouse. And it's the same spirit wanting to raise itself up above the Almighty and above the law. But it can't. It can't. And so many prophets are saying that between the eclipse and the Passover is 14 days. They say to closely watch and pray, be watchful, because they really believe that this is going to be a volatile window. There are so many things going on. And then again in history, it talks about the day that Jesus was crucified. Friday, April 3rd, AD 33, it was about 6:20 p.m. right after sunset. There was an eclipse, and it lasted till 7:11 p.m. If you go to the beginning of Genesis 7:11, it was judgment. That's when Noah was in the ark, and God opened up all the deep, and darkness came, and not a breath was left alive. So every time there's an eclipse, every time that there's something like that, it means judgment. There is some judgment coming. Now, we know that as people of God, we are not judged the way the world is. But let me tell you, it's time for us to get in line and say, Lord, where am I out of sync with you? Where am I not being obedient? What door do I have open in my life that I need to shut? Because I definitely don't want the floodwaters coming in my home. Amen. The Supreme Court is set to hear the presidential immunity case on April 25th, 2024, during Passover. Wow. That's not a coincidence, people. My God will have the last word, because that's who he is. It is mentioned that 31.6 million people are in the path of the totality of this eclipse. 31.6, if you put a colon there, it's John 3:16. Even further evidence that God is bringing judgment and looking, the eclipse, the start of the totality over New York, is at 3:16 p.m. And it's set to end at 3:29. What do we celebrate this year on 3:29, March 29th? The Lord. The death of our Lord Jesus Christ. The Lord is trying to get something across to his people. He's saying, come and know who I am. Call out my name. The Lord is warning the nations. He's warning the justice system. He's warning them. And he's going to have the victory, because he is the righteous judge, Almighty God. The judges are being judged. The leaders are being judged, and the people of this nation are being judged, and we need to humble ourselves and say, God, have mercy on our souls. Lord, open their eyes that they may see you, Lord. Jesus himself said that a wicked generation seeks a sign, and he himself said, Paul, there is no greater sign than Jonah. So this is a warning to leadership and to those being persecuted. Fully repent of everything that you're doing before the Lord and surrender yourself, your family, and all that you have to the Lord fully for the Lord to redeem. People, when the sun and an eclipse happens, there's a ring. It looks like a ring of fire, but it's actually called corona. Corona means crown. It's a crown of fire. My God wears a crown of fire because he is fire. And he's saying, I'm coming back with fire. And the eclipse falls on the Jewish calendar that starts the ecclesiastical year. Tell me God doesn't do things on purpose. He's saying, my church needs to rise up. Rise up, church, because I will have the victory. And are you going to follow me? See, God is clearly talking through the signs. Are we listening? Are we listening to what he's saying? We need to be more aware of what he's saying. And then not only that, the next blood moon is going to occur on March 13th, 14th of 2025. That is 11 months. People, 11 means judgment. judgment. And it's also on Purim, which means Purim happened in the days of Esther when God delivered the people. The world needs to watch out. We are going to declare the victory in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Hallelujah.
God is good. And what he put on my heart. And Miss Linda, you started it. You said a portion of it. I said, Lord, how do we pray about all this stuff? There's so much here. There's so much that it gets overwhelming, Lord. How do we pray? What do we do? And he said, Maria, I gave my disciples when they asked, how do we pray? And it's the perfect prayer. And he said, our Father, who art in heaven, the day we chose to believe that he is who he said he is, he said that we have the right to call him Abba. He is our Father. Hallowed be thy name. Lord, your name is above every other name. You are creator. You are king. You are God of gods. You are Lord of lords. You're Prince of Peace. You're everything we need. Everything we need. And then it says, let your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Lord, we pray for your perfect will to be done in our homes, in our churches, in our nation, and in this world, because it all belongs to you, Lord.
Thank you.
And Lord, we thank you that every day you give us our daily bread. You give us what we need, and what we need more is you. We need you more than the air we breathe and the food we eat, Lord. We need you desperately, Lord, and we are crying out as one body unto you, Lord Jesus. And Lord, thank you that you forgive us our sins. And Lord, give us a heart where we will forgive those. It doesn't matter what they've done, that we will forgive those so that we don't stand in that judgment seat before you, Lord. Give us a heart to forgive, Lord. And Lord, lead us not into temptation. But Lord, like Katie said, Father, that you would keep your angels around us to where you said that not, we will not stumble, we will not fall, but we will rise up on eagle's wings and we will run with you, Lord. And we will have the victory in the name of Jesus. Amen.
There's no God beside you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Oh, we praise you, Lord. We give you glory, Lord. We give you glory, Lord.
Let your will be done, Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you,
Lord.
For your kingdom, oh Lord, let it come, God. The majesty and power and glory of your kingdom, Lord. The signs and wonders and miracles of your kingdom, oh God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. We worship you. We worship you. We worship you. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Ah, what a mighty God. What a mighty God. What a mighty God. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Ah, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Lord, I thank you that you're the Almighty El Shaddai, the Almighty God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And you will tread down your enemies. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. And God, thank you that you're raising up the standard. Even though the enemy comes in like a flood, you're raising up the standard to stand against the enemy. Hallelujah. For we are more than conquerors in Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And we thank you, Lord, for your blood. The blood of Jesus, by the word of our testimony and the blood of the Lamb, we will overcome. We have overcome. Blessed be the Lord. Ah, Lord, tonight, thank you. Thank you for your people. Thank you, Lord, for those who will speak boldly, Lord, and declare the word of the Lord. For the word of God is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing, dividing asunder soul and spirit, the joints and the marrow, the discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart. Lord, reveal yourself in a mighty supernatural way. Thank you, Lord, for your people. Thank you, Lord, for these intercessors in this house tonight. Thank you for the boldness. Thank you, Lord, for the declarations, God. We stand in faith, Lord. And you are not a man that you should lie, nor the son of man that you should repent. But what you said you're going to do, you will do it. Hallelujah. And so we expect in faith, God, that you will do what you said. So tonight, Lord, bless your people, Lord. Those ones who faithfully join with us online, God, may they feel the power and the anointing that's in this room. May it flow right into their room right now. In the mighty name of Jesus. And we just give you praise. And God, we just have an expectation, Lord God, of what you're going to do. Lord, and we declare the best is yet to come for the people of God, for the people of the kingdom. Hallelujah. We thank you for it. Give you all the praise. And everybody said unto the Lord, amen. Amen and amen and amen and amen. Hallelujah. Oh, God bless those of you watching tonight. We bless you. And again, pray that you just sense that anointing of the Spirit. And all of those of you who are here tonight, bless you in the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah.